Here we go. And five.
Pop, pop.
Four.
Clap.
Three.
Clap, clap.
What up, y'all? Welcome to Here's the Thing. I'm Kev on stage. She's
that chick, AJ.
Welcome to another podcast episode. Smash that like button. Smash that notification. Bangers all 2021. Shout out to the Patreon, the Patreons.
Banger.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome to the podcast. Church announcements. First things first. I pop up. Freaks all the honey. First thing, keep your distance. The final one is this Friday.
The day before.
Okay, if you have the four pack, you're already good. Don't worry about it.
I got the four pack.
If you don't, buy the ticket. It's for my birthday.
My birthday
is Saturday.
Get the ticket if you can't
make it. I don't need a gift from you. All I want is you to buy a ticket to the show.
Go to the show, guys.
No, you don't got to send me a Rolex or ham. Just buy.
I love the versatility.
Well, I'm going to cancel my order.
Just buy a ticket to the show. Enjoy me doing stand-up, which I love. Another church announcement. The
you can do it.
Take your time. Come on.
Crafts and cocktails.
Amen. Yes, come on, somebody.
If you want to watch me and Angel completely sober for 20 some odd minutes.
Completely sober.
Completely sober.
Taking communion.
Taking communion. I mean, I was a complete normal person.
Oh, absolutely. He could have flown a plane.
I could have flown a fighter jet.
Fighter jet. The same.
In battle.
Yeah. Yeah, pretty much.
In battle.
As a
I was
man.
That sober. That I think sober. I was even more sober than I am right now.
Absolutely.
So check out that episode on the Kev on Stage Studios app. Also check out Denora.
Yes.
Angel's good friend.
Girlfriend on my channel.
That Chick Angel. It's a very funny show. Now you and Denora might have been a little tipsy. I was sober.
Interesting. 100%
So check that out and let you know. Angel pours strong drinks.
Y'all see Angel's a precision. I am a mixologist at heart. Did you know that I made your drink that way? Did you see that?
I saw you bite the lime, which is, that is unorthodox.
It's unorthodox, but you get more of the juice out.
I see. Yeah. You know, Angel, listen, she wasn't on Coyote Ugly. They said we got to make a special movie for her.
Oh, because I can't mix her with to be ugly, honey. Coyote pretty.
Okay. So check that out on the app. I'm not going to post that whole thing nowhere else. You got to pay to see that one.
Oh, yeah. No.
I ain't going to give that one away.
You cannot get it for free.
Nah, you're going to have to go over. You got to go over to the app. You got to go over. Okay.
Kevin.
Yes.
Are you so glad that you finally got to release whole pandemic?
Oh, you don't understand. How hard it was to hold on to that video. I planned that video for months. I had Angel's verse probably for at least 2 months.
I was like, are we still doing that thing?
You hit me up. Angel didn't know because I had to, Josh, throw it in there and just while we talk. You ain't got to play the sound. Just throw it, not now, in post. Pandemic. We had to have those outfits made, stitched. We had to get the girls' sizes. Imani had to choreograph the dance.
Yes.
Greg had to build a set by hand. They had to go out and get the mint paint. Couldn't find it. Don't know how Toby got it.
Wow.
They had to color correct that paint to mint in post.
Wow.
That's how doggone diligent we were. I talked to Toby probably every day, at least by Instagram DMs. We were talking about the Usman fight because Toby's Nigerian and the Nigerian dude knocked out Masvidal.
He murdered him.
He hit his hand down. He hit his hand down, then punched him in the face.
Is that legal?
Let me put it down just so I could punch you.
Yeah.
So I was talking to him that night about it because, you know, he was Nigerian. There was big Niger energy when that dude knocked that man out. And little did he know, that thing was already scheduled.
Now you were ready.
I woke up at 5:30 and just waited till 6. Like this.
Yeah, the launch code.
600 came on Instagram. Because you can't really schedule videos on Instagram IGTVs very well.
Yeah.
Post.
Just.
He hit me within 10 minutes.
Really?
Because he had just commented on a post I made. And he said his phone, he was like, man, I'm getting a lot of likes on this comment, which is random because it was just about the fight from last night. He said he hit my Instagram and watched. He had tears in his eyes when he FaceTimed me. He was laughing that hard. He had watched it like three times before he called me. He was like, he FaceTimed me like five times that day before noon. He was like, Kev, Angel had the beat machine and she threw it on the ground and stepped on it. It was like he was taking it in waves. It is probably my favorite thing I've ever, favorite piece of content I made in a good while.
It was so much fun. Let me tell you what, I'm just gonna be truthful. One of the things that made me go, oh my goodness, when Toby reposted it, Michael B. Jordan put laughing emojis. I said, Michael B. Jordan think we funny. him and all his muscles think we funny. Oh my God, I can't even, you can't tell me that I didn't win. I won, and I'm mad because I used to love Talib Kweli, but you know he been doing Wilding Out, but he also laughed too, and I was like, oh my God, oh my God,
it's great.
It was so good to see that they enjoyed it so much. Nail, she was just like, she couldn't take it,
and that's Nail's beat for real. Just in case y'all don't know, I also did. Toby didn't even know that. Nail had posted three instrumentals on her YouTube page, like. She told me about this when we did Aska, way back in my old house, where you and Marcus shot the Love Hour. And she was like, yeah, I'm doing this thing called instrumentals. I posted an instrumental every week. By the time the episode aired, she was just like, oh, maybe I'll just post three and never do it again.
Not ever.
So I was like, please let that beat be up there. And it was still up there. Downloaded that.
You grabbed that thing so quick.
Man, I think the reason I like it so much, I don't usually take my time with anything. I'd be like, I did shoot and make it, but you couldn't. You could not do that quickly. Like, I had to take my time and, like, plan.
It was perfect. It was so good.
And we sold an extra three tickets because of that.
I can't stand you for saying that. He's like,
one thing I know, them people will watch them videos and be like, flyer.
What?
Scroll.
Hold on, let me charge up for this scroll.
I mean, the scroll be... You would think that the ticket sales would be like, oh man, let me, no.
Cool.
They enjoy the video for what it is.
Your show would literally have to be more of those type of videos. You would have to be like, buy a ticket to see more of me.
I get it.
They're like, oh, it doesn't translate for me. I like the music video. But
the other stuff. But man, as a creative person, I was like, this is just. And the thing is, I think the best thing about 2020 is, two things happened that are changed my career trajectory. One, Angel looking more tanks to the actress.
Thank you.
Because I mean, and we just peas in a pod. We're unruly cousins. We're unruly cousins.
Yeah.
So that, and then Brennan and Transit in them.
Yeah.
Like Melissa had been telling me, she was like, you can't do what you want to do by yourself.
No.
You have to get a production team.
Yeah, you're right.
And by the grace of God, through the pandemic, I was introduced to Brennan and Tony and them for real. And Keep Your Distance. And then I had ideas and I had saw the different Keep Your Distance. And I was like, we could do sketches, saw what they did with Tony. And then was like, man, let's just do everything. And pretty much whatever idea I have.
They make it come to life.
And I shot that. Josh took the pictures. I went home. About 10 hours. I actually had the first draft that night.
It came so quickly.
Tony Valentino will direct it and then edit it himself.
Because he's so just, like, he's antsy like you.
Transit is a whole bunch of me's in different forms. Just as antsy to shoot and create, direct and edit. He has same skill. Brennan is the producing version of that. Amani is the head of post-production, but she's also a choreographer. And she's also a costumer.
Yeah.
And equally good at all three. She Very did the good. Costume for all the Keep Your Distance sketches.
Yeah.
And then I found out she was a dancer. I was like,
She's like, oh yeah, I got more skills and more skills.
Brent is also like the best drone pilot over there. Like, gets extra money being a cinematic drone pilot. Like, and then Dom was on tour with Beyonce.
And he's in Australia cameraman. Right now.
He's where?
He's on Australia directing a reality show.
He did On the Run 2. As the
he did, a? And he's
Dom was the on the run too Ryan's with Zia. Beyonce.
I smell him. Be like, do you still smell of her? No, everybody is super talented that I have had the pleasure of working with since I've worked with you. Josh, to everybody at Transit, to Josh, you, of course.
Video, photography, handsomeness. Oh, big screen, the Joshy cam.
I know, big screen.
Look at the big screen, it, Josh.
He ain't even fresh cut.
He just, this is just Tuesday AM handsome. I know. Don't let him throw the gold chain on.
Listen, if y'all follow my girl Brescia, he took a picture of her that is so fly. You would have thought they rented out a studio space.
And it now was he's adding living. That to his thing. Usually Josh's club picks dark and gritty. That's my style. But for Vogue fitters, your photo, her photos, bright and airy.
Listen, I knew. I said, listen, Joshua, come take my photos. I'm about now to post some more today.
Watch Melissa now. Now watch. Oh, creative God. List. Oh. You notice she didn't stop saying she ain't creative.
That stopped praise God. During the pandemic.
That stopped during the pandemic. Mm-hmm. She been shooting reels. She creative directs her own photo shoots. All these wedding pictures that you'll see. Shortly.
Oh my God.
She had me out there in the doggone ocean in a tuxedo with my toes out.
Y'all both looked so beautiful on the beach. I literally stopped everything. It was like, Marcus, look at them. Look at them just looking so beautiful.
She found me a tailor. I mean, not just a tailor, a person who made me custom suits.
Wow.
Off the rack, Kev is done.
What? Come on.
Oh.
1NC is out?
1NC is out of here. Oh, let me tell you what I never knew. Listen, I'm built awkwardly.
It's okay.
But when somebody measures you, they're okay. You hippie. Yeah. Okay. Oh, you thigh.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to make pants that fit that.
Sometimes you want them to be like, no, you can stretch that measure mark a little longer.
Yeah. Like,
no, it's this the number.
Let me tell you what I like, Joshy. A custom suit? Oh.
Yeah.
I said, hey, 10.
Give me 10 of them.
Because you know them off the rack, they big boxy.
They be all over the place.
The shoulders be up here.
Shoulders be big boxy. I used to take them off the rack from Macy's. Where?
And even when you get them tailored, Marcus be getting suits tailored, and it still don't hit the
it
way you want it to hit.
When they, oh, that's a word. Hey, come on. Because see, when, oh, yeah, that bullshit.
Come on, get
when
it.
David, single, come on, when single. David.
Single. Come on.
Was set to fight Goliath.
Hell.
They tried to hand him the armor of Saul.
The 1NC.
David, that's a 1NC. David put it on. He said, oh, this don't fit me. See, you want me to fight my battle your way. I can't fight my way and your way. Let me take off the thing that you think is mine. And let me put the sword down. I've been out here in the streets. I done fought the lion. And fought the bear. I don't need your armor. I need my custom fit. Custom when God chooses you, he didn't pick all of you. He picked you for your custom fit. David said, all I need is 5 smooth stones. All I need is my sling that I got. All I need is what God gave me. The Bible said. Well, maybe not the Bible, but I saw at my Todd Church.
Come on now.
All you have is all you need.
All you need.
I don't need nobody else. I can't get no help in Zion.
You gotta.
I'm telling you about to say dirty pop.
I was going to say, shut your white mouth. That's how you put a period on that. Shut your white mouth. Come
why
on,
mess?
Kev. That sermon had to come
up
out of you.
Yeah. That's all them years of good black church. These messages are just, they're ingrained.
Ingrained.
It don't take nothing because I done studied to show myself approved.
Come on.
Righteous. Sitting all them Bible studies and revival Sunday after Sunday.
Come on.
Sunday school, church, 3:30, 7:30. For 30 years.
30. I tapped out at like 18, 20, 20. Tapped out.
No lie, y'all. In 30 years, the first 30 years of my life, I probably missed Sunday morning service 5 times.
Mm-mm-mm.
If even that. Mm-mm-mm. If even that. Went on vacation and went to church.
I'm going to tell you what.
What's that, Angel?
I feel like the services I had to attend, the rant, because you know we had a church, and then my mother was like dip dabbing in other churches. So it was like I got a double dose. Like on Saturdays, they'd be like, oh, okay, the preachers from Tennessee are coming in.
So we got a preacher.
So we had to go sit at that, and they would be trying to get people to get the Holy Ghost. And I remember they had to have been homeless women, or maybe they were just older women. They reeked of piss. They reeked of piss.
They took you out the spirit. Like,
oh,
piss.
Yeah. I was like, if this is what it's like to get the Holy Spirit, I don't want it. If you got to piss on yourself to speak in tongues, I'm not. I wanted to buy them Depends. I wanted to buy them perfume. I wanted to buy them something. And I was like, if I had honey, I would have bought it for them because I would have gotten a discount.
You would have.
Because when you got honey.
Yeah.
Okay. A blessing is in store for you. Okay.
John the Baptist was eating honey.
Yes, he was.
And if he had honey, he would have got it for cheaper. He was out there paying wholesale prices for honey.
Right, because he didn't
know. Locust and honey? Who's your locust guy? John the Baptist?
He didn't know. And he was like, I know you got a promo code. I just don't know what the promo code
is. Yeah.
But I got other
stuff to do.
You
got to go
through the scrolls? You got to go through the scrolls? But now, if he would have had honey, we had locust with a discount.
With a discount. He would have felt all that savings. Oh, man. Y'all know. Y'all see that promo code. I know for me, literally, anytime I would go shopping and I would see the promo code online, I would go do a search. What is there a promo code for this? Searching, trying to save 20, 15% anything. Well, now I don't have to do that anymore.
Mm-mm, Angel, honey do it for you.
Honey will do it for you. Honey is a free shopping tool that scours the internet for promo codes and applies the best one it finds to your cart. Honey supports over 30,000 stores online. Let me tell you. I have personally put honey on my web browser so that, especially with us having bought this new house, there's so many things I need to do. I have, for the first time, a walk-in pantry.
Oh, I've been up in there. They had good snacks.
I got a walk-in pantry, but I got to organize it because I don't know what's in there. So having to buy all this stuff to organize. Amar's got his own room. I got to decorate his room. So all this stuff that I have to buy, I don't have time to be sitting there searching for promo codes. I just don't have it, okay? I got too much stuff to do. But with honey, I have been able to save money. I literally bought some baskets for the pantry, and I know I saved about, I think I saved a good $10.
$10?
$10. Okay, $10, because of honey.
Honey, honey, we going to save you money when you shop.
Okay, so this
no
is.
No more looking for promo code. Honey finds them just for you. And you save again and again and again and again. Every time you click, you search, you shop, you buy honey. Save you. You better go, Angel.
Yes.
Y'all can have that for free, honey. Put that on your website.
Yeah, put it on your website. No. So just this is how it works. This is how it works. Okay. When you're shopping on one of your favorite sites, when you check out, the honey button will drop down, and all you have to do is click apply coupons. Wait for a few seconds as honey searches for coupons it finds for that site. If honey finds a working coupon, you will watch the price drop.
That's all you got to do. It's just like really scanning simple. Your little rewards card down at your local grocer. You ain't got to look at sale. It's going to find it for you.
There you go.
It's quicker than putting your phone number in the thing.
If you don't really, if you don't already have honey, you could be straight up missing out on free savings. It's literally free, installs in a few seconds, and by getting it, you'll be doing yourself a solid and supporting this podcast. I'd never recommend something I don't use. Okay?
You wouldn't, Angel. That's what I know about you.
Get honey for free at joinhoney.com/SK.
SK.
That's joinhoney.com/SK.
SK. All right. Ooh. Let us talk about the Oscar Awards. Did you watch, Angel?
Of course I didn't.
No.
Okay, so here's I did. I watched some of it. Huh. And then we were shooting photos. I saw Daniel Kaluuya win Best Supporting Actor for his role as Chairman Fred Hampton in the Black Panther Party. I saw the first black makeup team win. Makeup and hair team win. And I was surprised by that, but then I wasn't, because it was like, how is a black person going to win when they wasn't making no movies letting black people be makeup and hair people?
And the fact of the matter is, a black person can be the head makeup or the key makeup artist for shows that don't have black people.
Yeah, that's just what I'm saying. They wasn't letting, I wasn't even talking about making black stuff. Talking about they wasn't letting black people.
You're right.
Listen, Angel will tell you, and you can probably explain it better than I can, why so many black people complain about not having good hair and makeup people on set. Ooh. But it's very hard to get black people. And can you explain why? Because I was talking to a hair and makeup person, and it's the union and the credits and all that. Just give it to them real quick.
Why
it's so hard.
So this is why it's so hard. The way the unions work out here is that you have to get either a certain amount of hours on a union project. However, a union project will not hire non-union people.
Right.
So you're already in a conundrum right there. You're like, how can I get on something that's not allowed to hire me? So a lot of people have to get hours by being on a project that starts off non-union and becomes union.
That's the end.
Yes.
Oh,
so
there, or I heard people can also be assistants to somebody.
Sometimes they can be assistants. And again, those are really hard. And this is the other thing. Most people, when they're like a key makeup artist, when they get another project, they bring the people that they've always worked with.
So I tell y'all, racism is a problem in Hollywood, but nepotism is as big of a problem.
Absolutely.
Because people don't feel racist when they're being nepotist.
Right.
They just feel like, I'm hook my boy and my girl up.
Right.
And if your boy and girl ain't black, you don't feel like I'm being racist or exclusionary. You just putting your people on.
Exactly. Because one of the things is they're like, if I know their work, because everybody is vying for a spot, right?
Mm-hmm.
Almost everybody in every position is vying for a spot. So they're like, I'm not going to try nobody new, because when I get over here and I got to impress this producer,
yep,
I don't want to get such and such that might be, you know, extremely late, doesn't work well with talent,
yep,
yada, yada, yada. So you get these people who a lot of times, most of the shows that I work on, the people that I work with are white. There are very few times where it's someone black. And even if they are black, doesn't mean, listen, when I worked on, I'm not going to say which show, they had a nice amount of black folk that were working in hair and makeup. They put me in the chair with the person who did not know how to do natural
mm-hmm.
hair. And I sat and watched him do things to my hair that my hair doesn't do. And I had to, because I am not a diva in that way, I had to politely be like, okay, so let me, we gonna start all over if you don't mind. I said, do you mind if I just jump in here? And he was like, oh, okay, yeah. And then he was like, oh my God, when he saw what I was doing, he was like, I was just messing you all up.
And
like,
you can't bring your own hair person.
No.
You can't bring your own makeup person because explain how the SAG won't let you.
Well, no. Now, if you are a star, like if you are, for instance, if you are, who's that guy who was in Rocky? Who's that black dude who played Apollo Creed?
Carl Weathers.
He was guest starring on the show that I will not name. And he had his own makeup artists come with him. But you have to be of that caliber. And then
so you
got to
be like number one of the call sheet.
Yeah. Well, he wasn't.
One
he was a
five.
Guest star.
Oh, okay. Got it.
He was a guest star. But you have to be of that caliber. And it's inside of your contract.
Oh, really?
Yes. That you have your own. But he's Carl Weathers. He was like a stunt casting.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like people know what type of character he is as soon as they see him. He's going to be playing the next boxer because people know who he is in Apollo or Rocky, excuse me. But unless you're that person, you got to do with whatever they have in the hair and makeup chair. And so that's why a lot of black artists will or actresses will do their own makeup before they go to work. Yeah. Do their own hair. On Atypical, they let me do my own hair.
I thought that.
Oh, yeah. That's why my hair got to change all the time.
I was like, that looked like Angel is doing her. Because I've been seeing black women, they come out of the trailer, especially when they're lower down. They'd be like, oh, my God.
Yes, because they be doing the most. And they want to spray. I have very sensitive scalp. And they be like, oh, yeah, we're just going to use this hairspray. And I'm like, what is that? Stop. Don't touch. What is? So for them, they're just like, these are all of the tools. How can I assist you?
Yeah.
Do you need anything? Which lets me know that some of these people in the hair and makeup industry are understanding that they don't know what they're doing.
Yes. But they're not going to turn the work down.
Oh, why? They get paid well.
They get paid no matter what. Now, I did a show a while ago. And I had my barber line me up. The set barber lined me up and jacked my beard all up.
Oh.
I'm talking about took a line all. Barbers love to show their crispiness, but they'll erase your natural hairline.
Mm. Well, I feel like they do that, too, to get you back in sooner.
Well, yes, because now your grow back's all messed
also,
up.
Also, remember that commercial that you did, and they tried to trim your beard? They're like, oh, yeah, is this not going to work on camera? And you
were I like, was like, fam, they had like They had somebody. First of all, they came over to my beard with scissors, and I was like, "Give me."
Yeah, he said, "No,
what y'all need done? I'll get it. Don't." Right. It took me 35 years to get this beard. 36, maybe even.
Mm-hmm.
To get this beard, you ain't finna mess it up.
Yeah.
But I'm low down, so I line me up. I'm lined. Mm-hmm. I'm lined. But anyway, I said all that to say, because sometimes I'd be like, man, the first black is still winning stuff. First black person is still winning stuff. Ain't that crazy?
And we've been around for a long time.
We've been around.
Since the inception of this country.
Yes.
And they're like, yeah, you still just
first black. So also an Asian woman won for best director.
Oh, really?
Chloe.
And now they be really ignoring Asian people in these Oscars. You hear me? They be like, who? What?
Yeah, she won for... I don't know how to pronounce her last name. I want. It's Z H A O. She's Chinese.
Z H A O. Zhao.
I don't know.
Listen.
She won Best Director for, I believe, Nomadland.
Mm-hmm.
Which I did not see, but I listen. If it can't be a black person, I'm gonna go POC. Or I'm gonna go woman.
Oh yeah, that's how I.
Anything but a white man. Mm-hmm. They win everything, which yeah. brings me to.
So I'm here.
That's how you're here.
Mm.
He's POC. Mm. Thank you very much. I am. You darn
which
right.
Which brings
you off.
Me to my big sadness.
What's
actually, Soul won too.
Yes, for
best animated
and the soundtrack. I thought
yes, mm-hmm. And Trayvon Free, who's somebody I follow on Twitter and follows me back. He won for that Two Distant Strangers,
mm-hmm.
the
Groundhog's Day.
Yeah, thing. Bless him. I'm happy for him. I couldn't watch. No, I didn't even know he made that. And Van Lathan, the dude from TMZ, black dude who got fired from TMZ, he produced that.
Oh, really? That's fantastic.
So he posted his win on Instagram, and the caption was at TMZ TV.
And
I
said,
oh, I love the petty.
The petty is strong with
petty.
Him.
Petty.
So we were doing real good.
Ciao.
Oh. I was like, here we go. Viola from Ma Rainey. Chadwick from Ma Rainey.
You thought that was going to happen?
I was hoping.
No.
I mean.
And the Oscars were like, okay, blacks, we gave y'all all that stuff. We ain't going to give y'all Chadwick.
Like, yeah, give
and her one for Judas and the Black Messiah.
Yeah.
Fire,
original
though.
Song. So she got two on her EGOT.
Mm-hmm, she
two down already.
She going to get on Broadway, do a couple of.
So the Tony. That's the hardest one for people to get.
Oh, yeah.
Because Broadway is most people who win EGOTs don't win for the same category.
No.
It's usually a producer on the Tony.
Do they normally come in from Broadway after winning the Tony?
Very rare.
What you mean come in from Broadway?
So, like, because I feel like it might be harder to do it the other way, right? Like, win everything else and then go back to Broadway.
The theater.
Broadway's a different beast.
I feel like Whoopi did it that way. Because she got a Tony for her one-woman show. I don't think she had her Oscar yet.
She got her Oscar for Color Purple, right?
Yes.
And she got her Emmy for a comedy album.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't get an Emmy for acting.
Oh, right. I can't wait for you guys to get an Emmy and a Grammy.
I know.
It's
going to be
fire.
My fireplace is big.
So I'm
going to
get a plaque, too.
What'd you say now?
I said, I'm going to photo the cover art, so I'm going to get.
Absolutely.
Be right
but Josh, you know what? You tucked in real good right now.
God is great.
I'm going to remind you real quick while we're talking about it. Your work is what got you here. Wasn't no luck, wasn't no thing. When you did work, I said, man, this dude Josh is good.
He's good.
And I also saw he was uninspired at all deaf. And I said, I know that look. Because I was uninspired at my jobs. And I was like, if you had me inspired, I could be good. But when he's inspired.
Josh is so talented.
Oh, he's the best.
Thank you, guys.
But anyway, so I was hoping, because I saw Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, I was like...
Oh, her Oscar was for Ghost. There we go.
It was for Ghost.
There we go.
She was nominated for Color Purple.
I can't even remember because I was
so nominated.
Young.
She was nominated, for sure.
I don't think I've seen Ghost.
Yeah, she definitely was nominated. It was for Ghost. Sorry, guys. Thank you.
He's
you haven't seen Ghost?
He haven't seen Color Purple.
He don't.
I don't know. I've seen Color Purple. I haven't seen Ghost.
You don't have to see either.
Yeah.
I feel like black culture is the only one that be like, if you ain't see this movie, you ain't us.
Well, he with us, so he got to see.
That's true. Do Mexican Ghost, people be like, if you ain't seen this, you ain't real?
Oh, we got to. Not really. Because movies were like, we always loved everybody else's movies because we just like.
I wasn't getting none.
Like, we're working hard. So we just be like.
Like, let me just watch something. I don't care.
Man. But if you're Mexican, you haven't seen La Bamba, are people like,
I think Selena was up there.
Or Selena.
I was going to say Selena, but then I was like, is that right? But yeah.
I was thinking that Selena too.
Yeah, Selena,
La Bamba was my movie when I was a kid. Big Richie Valens. I love Richie Valens. He died young. But anyway, so I was like, I thought for sure Chadwick was going to win.
You did. I think because a lot of people did.
So did you see Ma Rainey's Black Bottom?
I have not seen it, even though I'm a very big August Wilson's fan, but I just have not had the...
August Wilson's?
I know. I added all the S's. August Wilson's fans.
August Wilson's the fans. Why are you
adding those? Because I was adding
August
Possession.
August Wilson fan. The I know. Possession go on the end, but without the extra S. Because you're a fan of August Wilson, but you're not August Wilson's fan.
I am August Wilson's fan.
No, no, you are August Wilson. Oh, you see what August I'm Wilson's fan. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Maybe, but you didn't say I'm August Wilson's fan. You said I'm a fan of August Wilson's. So I think it's the yeah.
Oh, I flipped it around.
I think that because when you said it that way, I was like, no, that's right.
Yeah, but you know what she was trying to say. So.
Yep.
Wilson's.
I know what you're trying to say.
But I haven't been in the mood to watch it.
I get it. Uh-huh. I totally understand. Mm-hmm. I love historical stuff anyway. I didn't know much about Ma Rainey. Mm-hmm. And the way they were promoting the movie was like she was on her business and she was trying to be owning stuff and she was in control. And I was like, yes. Mm-hmm. You should watch Viola Davis tell these white people what she ain't finna do for 2 hours long. It will restore your soul. Everything the locust and the cankerworm have taken.
Oh, yes.
It will, because she was, all them white men were like, do this. She was like, give me a Coke. They were like, mother. And it better have the droplets on the outside. Oh. And I'm not going to start until I get me a Coke.
I love it.
So I thought Chad was a shoo-in. Mm. Oscars will give stuff to people based on circumstances. You cannot tell me they did not give Leo the Oscar for The Revenant because of the Oscars that he might have should have won earlier. Mm-hmm. Because that performance wasn't to me, uh-huh. And I like Leo. I'm not even being like shady. Mm-hmm. There was nothing about this that was like, now this is what he deserved. Because mm-hmm. It's people.
Yeah,
it's not a computer. It's like, man, we probably owe him one. Mm-hmm. So I thought, okay, Chadwick had a great performance and he passed away that year. Mm-hmm. He should win. Anthony Hopkins?
Hopkins.
Mm-hmm. He didn't even come.
He was in Wales.
He was in Wales.
Golf course.
Yeah.
I was like, that place looks nice.
He looked like he was in Game of Thrones. outside of the castle.
I saw a dragon. It was flying in the background.
So Anthony Hopkins was like, hold on, what? Chad, we finna win. I ain't finna come all the way to America during a whole Pandulce?
Yeah, he's like, I don't know.
Right. And then he won. He turned his video in today.
Bittersweet.
He's like, he's 83. He's like, man, hold on.
What did you give me?
Hey, man, thank y'all. Chadwick should have won. Really? Basically what he said. This is really honor to Chadwick. What an amazing star.
God rest his soul.
Gone too soon. Thank y'all. I ain't gonna hold you. That was the energy of his. It was 37 seconds.
He was like, that's all y'all getting from me.
At my age,
right?
I was not winning this. I am on vacation. My toes are out in this whale sand.
He's like, I don't care. Yeah. I've done everything I need to do. I did not think that Chadwick was going to win.
Why you didn't, Angel?
Because I know this town. His nomination was their ode to him.
Somebody said that, right? And it was a black person. She was like, I watched all the performances. His nomination was his.
Yeah, that was it.
Nod. I that's why I say I can't say this. Uh-huh. And as a black person, I show Will Root, and I ain't seen damn other movie.
Oh, absolutely.
What? Chadwick was robbed when Moonlight lost. I was like, I hadn't seen either movie
Moonlight
at the time.
Got the pump fake though.
I know, but when they had at the moment they lost, I was like, how La La Land go win over Moonlight? That movie, so good. What was about Miami and stuff. Barry Jenkins. And then they won, I was like, you doggone right. And still ain't seen La La Land.
Yeah, I haven't, and Moonlight. I still ain't seen it. I ain't seen Moonlight either, though.
So I feel like I don't care, but I'm going, if black people are nominated and didn't win, we got robbed.
You robbed us. Yeah, I was not expecting him to win. Not to say that I think Chadwick was a phenomenal actor in everything that he's done for pretty much. Like it was before he passed. I watched the James Brown movie, and I was like,
"Get on up!"
I was like, "Sir,
yeah, man." And he learned to dance for real, Angel.
I know. Mm-hmm. I was like, the athleticism. This was a huge undertaking, anyways. But I did not expect for Hollywood to all of a sudden get sentimental over a black man because of his death. I just did not expect it. So I took the nod as a, he can now say, because I don't think he ever was an, well, he can't, his family can say.
Yeah.
That he was an Oscar-nominated actor.
Yeah. And people who saw Anthony Hopkins' movie was like, bruh, to give Chadwick the win over Anthony Hopkins would have been condescending. Mm-hmm. They were like, this is Anthony Hopkins. Like, y'all, I know we... And I'm talking about black people in the film industry. Not yeah, just yeah. people on Twitter. People who I follow who are really producers. They was like, y'all, trust me. Mm-hmm. If they would have gave this to Chadwick because he died, it would have been... It would have been like, here you go.
But right.
You,
that's what I'm
and saying. I don't think Chadwick, and I don't know Chadwick well, never met him. Or actually, well, Melissa met him in the grocery store, and she was very excited. Mm. But to, just what he gave off, I don't think he would want to have been given anything he didn't feel like he had earned.
Yeah.
But I can't speak to that, because mm-hmm. all I saw was him, mm-hmm. and he was robbed. He
had performances in the recent past, like the last couple of years, that could have been nominated, I feel like. But I felt like he was going to get the Nipsey treatment. I thought they were going to give yeah. one, but then that brings its own argument. Oh, right. You didn't give him the flowers when he was alive. You know what
yeah.
I mean? It's a double-edged sword, but I thought he was going to win, too. Oh. Oh.
I did, too. And I thought Viola was going to win. It's been 20 years since a black woman has won Best Actress.
Has it been 20?
It's been 20.
It was 20 years. Holly, oh, my gosh. Barry. I remember I was in my apartment. You are right. I cried. I did cry
you,
on that.
When Holly won?
Yes, I did. Mm.
It made her feel good.
Yes. Yes. I want you to make me feel good.
I was watching that movie at my pastor's house with him, and that scene came on. I was like, oh, God. Yeah. I like this, but I cannot show
it. I cannot watch it. Yeah, once I saw the movie, I was like, okay, she got a good chance of winning this.
Holly?
Yes.
Yeah.
And then when she did win, and when she didn't waste her speech... That's why I was just like, because she could have wasted that thing.
Yeah.
But she, I mean, when she said Vivica Fox's name ain't never graced the Oscar stage, nor will it ever again, more than likely. I said, that's what you better bring up the people that will never get the benefit of being in your shoes. It made me tear up because I was just
you
like,
you don't think yeah. they're going to give it to Vivica for two to play that game for?
Listen. They ain't gonna know who she is. Vivica's face didn't change so much. They were like, who are you, ma'am? Who? I mean, I still think Vivica's gorgeous, but she's also a very sweet human being. But her face didn't change a lot since when she first got out here.
Independence Day, Vivica, she is, and now it's very much different.
Very much different. Very mm-hmm. much different. I don't know if it's the money. I wonder what happens. And I know... that I will be very wealthy one day.
Mm-hmm. What?
Yes.
Sooner than later.
And I'm excited about it. And I'm just constantly trying to remember not to be crazy, you know, because I don't know what happens to these people. You know what I'm saying?
No, I do.
You look at them and then the people that you have aspired to be like, you know, from when you were sitting at home just watching them, and then now that you're an adult and you're looking at them and you're just like, huh, were you crazy then?
Yeah.
Or did the money turn you crazy?
They say the money reveals more of who you already are.
Ah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. See, that's why I'm going to do my banking with Chime so that it can help me remember who I am.
Oh, my God.
And reveal me in a non-crazy way, because Chime is not crazy. Chime is the type of bank that you want to be dealing with, so that when you're reminded of who you are and it shows you who you are, it shows you as a sane person. Mm-hmm. Okay, because a lot of these banks will drive you crazy.
Yes, they will.
They will drive you insane. They got a fee for everything.
Everything.
I'm like, why are you charging me when you got my money?
Absolutely.
I am giving you the blessing of holding my money. But the blessing, okay, to hold my money. But you want to hide all these type of fees. Look at your bank statement and you like, wait a minute, what? Wait a minute. I had to have a monthly minimum. Why are you putting me on watch? I should be able to have however much I'm going to have in here. If it's going to be $5 this month, let it be $5. Don't be charging me. Well, Chime has an award-winning app and debit card. and there are no hidden fees and no monthly premiums, okay? After all, you earned the money, so you deserve to keep. That's what I'm saying. You earned the money. You deserve to keep. I worked for this money.
Yeah, you did.
So why you take from me?
Why you take from me?
I don't get it. I don't understand. But Chime understands.
Wow. Chime understands.
You get your paycheck, benefits, stimulus checks, tax returns up to 2 days earlier with direct deposit.
That's stimmy.
Ooh, early, what? Plus 38,000 fee-free ATMs with MoneyPass and Visa Plus Alliance. Turn on alerts to let you know your card is used and instantly block your card if something seems fishy. Come on, somebody, because people out here stealing stuff from folk. And when you see it happening, you want to be able to say, pause. Don't let nobody make any other purchases. Let me tell you, what I appreciate about something like Chime and Chime as a company, a lot of times we have grown up thinking we have to be with these old school banks, that we got to be with these brick and mortar banks.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't realize all those fees is to pay for their old school way of doing
Absolutely,
things.
Absolutely, Angel.
And they don't care about you, right? So with Chime, one, really easy to set up. Two, you're able to access your money from so many different places.
Yeah.
Three, these fees, especially if you're young. A lot of our listeners are around our age and younger. And so you might not be at the place that you want to be at financially. So you honestly can't afford to be having a bank taking money from your account right. every month. So to have a company,
bless you, Kevin.
God bless you, like Chime, that is not up in your pockets like that, that's allowing you to build your capital, allowing you to put your bread where it's supposed to be and it still be there when you come back to get it, it's something like no other. All right? So join the millions on Chime. Sign up. Takes 2 minutes. 2 minutes!
Como dos minutos.
And it doesn't affect your credit score. Apply now at chime.com/SK.
SK.
That's chime.com/SK.
SK.
Chime is a financial technology company. Banking services provided by the Bancorp Bank or Stride Bank NA. Members FDIC. Eligibility requirements and overdraft limits apply. Overdraft only applies to debit card purchases. Limits start at $20 and may increase up to $100 by Chime. Early direct deposit depends on the payer. Out-of-pocket cash withdrawal fees apply. Third-party and cash deposit fees may apply. Go to chime.com/SK for details.
S-K-A.
Now, you guys, y'all know we sold our house. And one of the things that made it easy to sell our house is that the house looked pretty
yes,
on the
did.
Outside. Okay, you came, you saw the lushness of the lawn. The lawn was green. You hear me?
Was it because of Sundays?
Oh, you know it was because of Sundays. Sunday had my lawn so green, luscious, and pretty.
It was looking green every day.
Every day. They said, is the grass green on the side? Yes, on our side. It stays
your
green.
Your side of the grass.
Fence.
Oh,
the
fence. Sorry. Better, I, John.
Nah, it was
your side of the fence.
Fence.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Yes. But it was because of Sunday. Let me tell you, especially out here in California, the sun knows how to torch grass. What
Bruh.
I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. It'd be green one day, you go out there the next day, you have hay. Well, with Sunday, we were able to restore our grass so easily, so quickly. It's a lawn care product, and what they do is they take pictures of your lawn from satellites, right? And they figure out, based off of your desire for what you want your grass to be like, they figure out a plan, a treatment specifically for your grass.
Wow.
And the application is so easy. You literally are hooking up the stuff they send you because they mail it directly to your door. You hook it up to the hose. You spray your grass off. They even tell you what day to do it and then what day to do the next
thing. Is that right?
Yes, I'm talking about it is a no-brainer. This is not tilling up your grass, laying down manure. This is literally spraying your
it's
grass.
It's plug and play or plug and spray.
Am I right? The ingredients are natural, which is we're very big on that because we have young kids that like to play in the grass.
Mm-hmm.
And we have dogs, so we're not trying to get them sick. And they also have add-ons like a weed control, seeds, pest control. And I will say Marcus has been the one to take care of our yard because I don't have a green thumb. But when Sundays, I could do it. I didn't have to wait on him. I was like, I got it, baby. Let me just get the hose and plug it up and spray. And I was able to do it all on my own. Didn't have to wait on him. I was empowered by Sundays. So, Sunday explains exactly what you get and why, and everything is waiting at your door when you need it. All I had to do was attach the ready-use pouch to the garden hose and spray. Lawn care used to take up all day. Now it takes less than 15 minutes.
Wow.
Let Sunday take the guesswork out of growing a greener, more beautiful lawn this spring, because you need it, okay? Visit getsunday.com/SK
SK
to get $20 off your custom lawn plan at checkout. That's $20 off your custom plan at getsunday.com/SK
SK.
All right.
During the Oscar party at Jamie Foxx's house.
Come on.
By the way, speaking of Jamie Foxx and David Alan Greer.
Ooh, talk about it.
Let's just play a little clip.
We're going to talk about it.
Somebody in the chat brought this up, and I said, well, you know what? We might as well, since we got a little podcast to discuss things. We'll get to Jamie Foxx in a second.
Thanks for chopping it up with us. I'm Kev on stage.
Wait, let me set the stage for you.
Oh, Joe.
I did a Netflix. Oh, sorry. That was my sheesh with my kids. I did a Netflix roundtable with Jamie Foxx, Spice Adams, and David Alan Greer. Shot for about 30 minutes. Jamie Foxx and David Alan Greer love Spice Adams.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know me that well.
I'm Kev on stage.
Love you, Spice. Spice, come holler, man. Come work.
Yeah. Let's do it, man. Let's do it.
Other dude, you too.
Yeah, hey, man, it's cool. Yeah, I was in here with y'all. It was great.
Other dude, you too.
Other dude, you too.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to do.
So when that happened in real time, let me just set more of a stage for
Please
you guys.
Tell me.
When they got on the call, it was obvious. Everybody knew Spice. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're just the best of friends. David Alan Greer and Spice have been known each other 20 years.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so they actually know him.
They're friends.
Oh, okay.
Jamie Foxx, I don't know how well he knows Spice. So when I'm setting up, you know, Netflix got me and Spice. Spice never mentioned that he knew David Alan Greer and Jamie Foxx very well. He's just like, oh, yeah, Cam, let's do this thing.
Come work.
Come work.
Yeah.
Oh, we love you.
Spice was like, yeah, I'm going to come work.
They were kind. They were nice. They were professional. They ain't no Kev, which obviously I'm not traditional Hollywood. Mm-hmm. It's not surprising.
Yeah.
Big fan of Jamie Foxx. Missed the golden opportunity to tell him how much I loved his Brady Bunch joke because I was trying to be professional. Mm. I was like, should have told him. Love David Alan Greer. He jumped on earlier than Jamie Foxx. So we were chopping it up about Living Color, things like that. Nice guy.
Mm-hmm.
Nice guy. And they're comics. There's a certain, bust your balls because of comics.
Is he from Detroit
too? I don't know.
Oh, somebody in the chat said they're both from Detroit.
No,
I think that is true, actually.
They know each other for so long.
They were talking about Detroit-based high schools and things of Cartiers and stuff.
Yeah.
Jigging. I don't know what it's called.
I can't say it. Jigging and whatnot.
So, but when David Alan Greer said other dude, I collected another.
Which one was called?
Infinity Stone.
What was that one?
This is the respect.
Ooh!
My name is my name stone. This is the Marlowe from The Wire stone.
Mm.
I've got the rejection stone from Hollywood, the passed on stone, plenty of those. I don't have all my Infinity Stones.
You got racism office stone. Is that one in there?
Oh, racism office stone. I still go by there and pee.
And use the trash can.
I still go by there and throw their trash away just every so often. Mm-hmm. I go down that thing and I throw my trash in there.
Uh-huh.
When he said, and I know he was joking.
Right.
I know he was joking, but when it hit me, I was like, my cousin texted me this. I'm going to share this with y'all so y'all know. And then he texted me this out of the blue. This is my cousin on my dad's side.
Oh, look at you.
Not that dad.
Oh, okay. Look at you.
Oh, my God.
He's like, no. You're confused. No, this
is Willie D side, not my birth father.
Willie D.
That's Willie O'Kale. He texted me this, and I said, you must have talked to God for real, because this spot, I didn't even know he was working in the office of a prophet. He said this, it was like Sunday at 8:39 during the Oscars. I really wasn't thinking about nothing. I think I was down at dinner with my wife, taking our anniversary pictures. God said to tell you not to worry about not getting the respect you feel you deserve from those you feel should give it. He hears you. For his purpose, he doesn't need for you to be full, but constantly hungry. It's not meant for you to be satisfied. Your birth will come from hunger and the drive that hunger produces to far exceed what you plan for yourself. Use the hunger to feed the people. Wow. So every time when you don't get booked, you have and I'm not even being shady because you book as well. You have an amazing ability to not let it graze you. I take everyone personally.
You take it right to the middle of your soul or your heart. That's how you take it.
I had a pitch yesterday with a network that I had pitched 2 months ago. Mm-hmm. They passed on something. And when I'm on the Zoom call, I thought, like, man, this lady looks familiar. I don't know where I know her from. She's like, oh, yeah, you pitched us last month. And, you know, I know that project wasn't right for us. But we liked you. I said, y'all did pass on that thing. I remember you pitched her. And she was like, no, it wasn't. I get it. I'm not hurt at all. Mm-hmm. You're going to get passed on it more than you get accepted. But it only takes one yet. But I'm telling you, when those things happen, I'm just like, okay.
Kev's in the back like,
oh yeah. We're all having a great time.
Kev gets his pen out.
We're all having a great time. But then this clip will play. And I want you all to hear this. Because this is my driving force.
I've heard this clip several times working with this man.
Shut your white mouth.
No.
You can do it. Live with your own self.
I knew it. Oh,
boy.
Where did that bring you? Back to me.
Woo, Thanos! You could not live with your own failure. And where'd that bring you?
Back to me.
Oh, there was a... I'm just going to share this. Maybe I shouldn't, but it's too late. I'm not going to share it.
Okay, make up your mind.
I'm going to share it.
Okay.
Oh. There was a show I auditioned for. Mm-hmm. Many months.
Mm-hmm.
Many months.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, they chose someone else.
Chose someone else.
Because I was free during the shooting dates.
Yes, you were.
Then I was like, well, you know what? That didn't work out. I'm going to go back on tour. We're going to shoot stuff for the app. Do what we do. Right. Ain't going to cancel that.
Stay focused.
Yeah. Stay focused, my G. 2 months later, my reps hit me. Hey, production had a change of heart and was wondering if you're available now.
Mm.
Oh, what?
NAACP.
We want to go in a different direction, and now we want to see if you're free.
Got a little nomination in between there.
With your own failure.
Ha ha ha.
Where did that bring you? Back to me.
And the thing is, I ain't going to hold you. I'm not even being petty. I'm already booked now. I'm not going to cancel tour dates for this. Not for them people who want to see me. We selling out.
Selling out.
I'm not going to cancel the show we're shooting on the road now because, you know, now you had a change of heart. Mm-hmm. I didn't do nothing different, but I know what happened. Oh, y'all booked them people.
Oh, yeah.
And y'all went in there and y'all shot an episode or two and you said, maybe we should have went with Kev.
And then Kev wasn't NAACP nominated, Kev, when y'all rejected him.
Wasn't even like, NAACP Image nominated.
And they're like, see, had we known that that was
That's the same on how do you spell
on Sanjay?
That's Kevon.
Mm-hmm. Oh, how did that happen? Oh,
and
no.
Listen, I ain't gonna hold you, man. Something's happening in the waters in my life.
Oh yeah.
Let me tell you what I notice about people when they see you doing it without them. They come scurrying. Hold on.
There's been an awakening in the force.
And now I'm not, I promise y'all, I'm petty, but I don't hold grudges like that. Yeah. I'm not gonna cut off my own nose to spite my face.
Come on, amen, amen.
But
that's
now,
the word.
So now when we're having the conversation, it's like, here's what I'm doing, here's what y'all can take or not. Mm-hmm. But I mean, I stepped out of a shoot to take this call. I was 6 minutes late to a pitch yesterday because I was so enthralled in what I was shooting. And I'm not even proud of that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just... Melissa was shooting something that I am very excited about.
Oh,
I will let her announce it when it's time.
Please.
But I looked at my calendar and the person, the rep texted me like, yo, are you going to be able to jump? And I was like, oh, snap.
Mm-hmm.
My bad. I took a pitch in the soundstage green room on my phone.
Look at you.
With the execs. And I'm not even flexing. I was just like, hey, man. Oh, hey. This is what we're doing, man. Love it, love it. Don't like it, don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
And right. They like, oh, we really want. They when they want to work with you, it's a different conversation. But we'll save that for Dream Talk. Uh-huh. I want to go back to something. The reason I brought up Jamie Foxx because Tyrese was at his house, and he went viral for this. And it's we're not going to harp on Tyrese for other reasons, but he shaved his girl's coochie.
He's been cleaning up.
What happened? You are hilarious, Josh.
What happened?
The same day he hosted an Oscar party with other people there, the Shade Room posted him shaving his girl's coochie, and I said, man.
It was the post for me. It was the...
Here we go. As we prepare...
Here comes the airplane.
Oh, my God. People will share anything. Never with the sound effects. Why do you share that? Why do you share that? Why are you sharing? You doing maintenance.
He's an odd man.
This would have been a great transition into Sunday, but you've already done it. But why would
because
you
because it's been a
that?
Whole pandemic. European wax should have been closed. You got to get in that thing. You want to get this off of that?
Right.
Get in there and take care of yourself.
Oh, no. Not
you want to take care of the little...
That's a little rug.
You want to take care of that little rug? You want to take care of that civil rights movement?
But it ain't got to be a... It don't have to be an Instagram post. It don't... You, listen, don't nobody want to go on to that chick Angel and see...
Oh, no,
this.
Angel.
No, nobody wants to see this. It's a pan, the pan.
Scoot it over, little Angel.
The pandose has been rough.
Ah, you have those slippers.
It's been a rough time. Nobody wants to see that.
Don't get Angel.
Nobody.
Please take her away. Defund the police. Hey, but before you do, arrest those sandals.
Yeah, now listen, I will never. Chewbacca's up.
Back to look at.
Listen, we all know there have been those of us who have been looking.
Oh, no.
Doran. And we have tried to do their own waxing and had their labia glued shut for a day or so. You about done killed yourself trying to do your own maintenance, and then you got to you make it out by the hair, literally by a hair. Exactly.
Not the chin,
a hairball.
Right. Exactly. You about to die.
Liz, you try to eat the coochie. You got to part it first. Hold on. Let me just. You got to lay it down. You got to put a clip in it. Hold it to the side. Put some wave grease.
Put Bobby pin this.
God, let me just braid it down first. I'm finna eat you, but hold on. Let me just braid it down.
I'm gonna be honest. I have tried to do this on my own, and I thought I was gonna have to call the ambulance. I didn't even want to look down there to see what I had did. I was like, I don't know if I'm bleeding out. I don't know if I only have one left down there.
Angel, what? Walking like a
Mar all week. Yes. I'm like, I don't know what I did.
I done waxed my lip off.
I'm about to bleed out.
Something's missing.
Hopefully I paid up my life insurance that I got through Policy Genius because I might die here on this floor. But thank God for Policy Genius. I got the policy that was the most affordable and right for me. Oh my goodness, you guys. If the pandemic ain't taught us nothing, we don't know what the heck is going to happen.
Man,
we do not know. We don't know which way is left, which way is right. But I can tell you the right way to get your insurance is with Policy Genius.
Amen.
You don't want to leave your family not secured. And I know trying to shop for insurance policies can seem so daunting. There's so much paperwork. There's so many things that you just don't understand, and you just want somebody to have your back that's going to make sure that you are getting the policy you want and the policy you deserve. So with Policy Genius, it's fantastic. They can help you compare top insurers in one place and save 50% or more on life insurance. Once you find your best option, Policy Genius team will set you up. Set up your new policy for you and answer any questions you have along the way. And you can feel good knowing that your family is financially protected. Now, I know we have more than just black people in the audience, but black folk, we got to stop just leaving furniture for our family.
And heartache. All you left was a headache and pain.
Right. That's it. We got to start leaving our legacy something to be able to use for the future. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I'm sorry, old pots and pans is not what I'm talking about. That is not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about some money so that you can make it through a year or something. Mm-hmm. And having Policy Genius allows you to know how much coverage you need and compare quotes to find your best price so you can do that for your family. Since their licensed agents work for you, not the insurance companies, there's zero hassle. So if you hit any speed bumps in the road during the application process, Policy Genius will take care of everything. This kind of service has earned Policy Genius a 5-star rating across thousands of reviews on Trustpilot and Google. Best part, all the benefits of Policy Genius, the comparison tool, the handling of the paperwork, and the unbiased advice are totally free for you to use. So this is what we want you to do. Policy Genius can promise that you won't leave their website feeling like a fool, okay? We don't want you feeling stupid. They're not going to do it. You can save 50% or more by comparing life insurance quotes and feel good knowing that if something happens, your loved ones are taken care of. Go to policygenius.com to get started. Policy Genius. When it comes to insurance, it's nice to get it right. But why was he shaving her vagina, her labia? Somebody on Instagram, what?
Patreon said, condition her.
Condition me?
No. Her, the girl.
Condition her. Yeah, no, listen, I had recently, I'm not going to tell y'all this, but I'm going to tell you just a little piece. I'm not going to tell y'all, but I'm going to tell you a little piece. I had a recent situation in the grooming process that was so ghetto that I felt traumatized. But at the end, the woman was pulling paper off of my butt. I'm trying to get, she's just pulling paper off of my booty. She's like, just like if I, Baby Yoda, give it to me.
Oh,
if
no. Take care of my son.
If I'm Baby Yoda and I'm trying to get my bottoms on, she's like, okay. Oh. I wanted to be like, ma'am, please stop touching me. There we go. I knew something had went wrong when she only charged me like $20. I was like, I know how much work you just did. So obviously things did not go right.
Something's wrong.
Now I was like, she was like, $20. I was like, what just happened? I was like, there must be a camera somewhere. I'm about to be on somebody's website. Tell
you
what,
I did not realize the thought, right? You know, a lot of women get waxed mm-hmm. nowadays. And, you know, they get the full Brazilian. Butthole open.
No hoping.
To a stranger.
Yeah.
The first time that happened, y'all tooting that thing up.
They seeing all of the inside.
And they looking all up inside your crevices.
I had to eventually tell that woman, just leave some down there. It's fine. I am done. That's what I said. It's fine. It is fine. It is okay. I don't care what it is. It could be patchy. I don't care. But yeah, your whole in some
like whole butt.
The first time you do it, you think, is everybody this naked when they do this? Or, and then you realize there's no other way for them to get there.
You got to toot that thing up for a stranger.
Toot that thing up.
And they got to see you out here marching for civil rights. Mm-hmm. After the pandemic, when European waxers are over, they're probably like, Oh, yeah.
My girl, she was in there. She knew I was coming. She was like, give me a second. I know what we got to do. Give me a shake. It's going to be in here for a while.
With a machete. Before I get to waxing, I got to just cut some of it. We out here in the Amazon.
Oh, yeah.
What is that? A Chick-fil-A gift card? How'd that get stuck?
Lucy, my girl, it's so funny because halfway through she does this, she has to do that, and I'll be like, I know.
The kid walked in like a natural labor. This is my mother's machete.
Get to the work. Get to work.
Out here singing hymns.
Oh, yeah.
No more, my Lord. No more.
Get in there.
My Lord.
You darn right. I remember one time this woman was like, oh, so much ass. That's the wrong hair, not down there.
She said that?
She said it out loud to me. Waist naked. Waist below naked.
It's supposed to grow.
Yeah, she said, oh, so much hair. It's supposed to grow here, not down here. I was like, I know. If you could just get about your business. Get about your business. and get this, please. I've been through a lot in the waxing arena. Yeah, so I when Marcus was to play, I'd be like, "You listen, what you're not doing is what I've had to do, and I don't want to hear about it no more." Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's been something. Oh no, did the sound go out again?
Y'all just got to bear with us, man. We almost done. I ain't gonna hold you.
Is the sound back?
It's back.
Oh, okay.
So I want to say this one thing about DMX's funeral, and this is not sad. His processional through New York.
Yes.
They put DMX's casket in a monster truck.
Yes, they did.
A humongous.
It was as tall as a building. It looked like.
It was like the biggest monster truck I've ever seen. Every motorcycle in New York.
Yeah.
Was in its processional, and it was the most DMX thing I have ever seen. I was like, that's how DMX should go out in New York.
It is so beautiful when I feel like people get people's homegoing services right.
Yes.
When they get them right. And I understand, like, can't all of them be right, but I feel like this one, they really just did something that I felt like was just poetic.
It was so great. And I'm glad, like, when DMX passed, people start sharing all these random things he did. He had mopped the floor for somebody. He was in the back making his own food at IHOP. All these people had these great stories to share. And that's really, he didn't seem to feel like his life was wasted.
Mm-hmm.
He seemed to feel like his life was fulfilled. And it was just amazing to, I want to go out in a monster truck. And I'm not known for trucks, but I just was like, will draw attention.
I will remember this. What is it? So on the 28th, when this posts, it'll be April 28th. If by chance the rapture don't come before you go, or I don't go before you go, I'm going to make sure.
You put me in a monster truck. Down Rodale.
I'll be like, Liz.
Get all the
blacks. Get him in one of his custom-made suits, and we putting him in the back of a monster truck. Drag him all across Ventura Boulevard.
But it was just great, man. I was just like... And I'm so happy. I know we said this before, but I'm so happy he got to do the verses.
I mean, it was just like, it was such a gift to be given that, especially to see how jovial he was.
Yeah. And just
that, you know, it was a great way to have a, you know, because the last big memory we had of him before that was him on Ayana.
And yeah. We don't want to remember like that.
No, we don't. And so I'm glad that got to be the last memory. The most memorable thing we have of him.
Reminded people how many songs he had, because when that came out, they was like, oh, Snoop, he ain't got nothing on Snoop. And then when you listen, you're like, yo, DMX has a lot more songs than I realized.
Oh, yeah, DMX.
Slippin' is one of my favorite songs of all time.
Bruh. Also, man, I wish I had saved this thread. Dang. There was a thread, because it felt like DMX burst on the scene to me. Because I didn't live in New York. I don't think you did.
No.
I don't think Josh was alive.
Okay.
But it felt like DMX burst on the scene with his signature sound. And this New York hip hop journalist, I wish I could find the story. Did you see this? I was there when you watched it. Okay. His sound was developed for many years before that. Mm-hmm. You could see flashes of his sound. And then it was like this mixtape, that mixtape, this mixtape, that mixtape. And then the year he blew, it was like he had finally like zeroed in on that. And that really kind of made me happy, because it was like, when you don't see the growth process, it feels like, oh, this person just popped on the scene and that was developed. He was like 28, I believe, when his first album dropped. But that sound had been developed for a lot longer. And that was just really inspiring to me, that it wasn't just automatic for him. Like, it rarely is like that for people.
It rarely is. I think the only reason why people want to believe that is because it takes accountability away from them not being amazing.
You hear that, baby, yo? Grogu. I got to call you by your birth name. Grogu. You want to be a great Jedi? You can't do it quickly.
You can't.
You hear what Angel said? You can't make it. You got a lot of powers undeveloped. You got to send her to Luke and you got to learn how to control that thing. You ain't going to be fast, baby. You 50 already. We thought you was a baby. You just small for your age.
Just small
for you got to learn to control that thing. Don't be sad. I feel you.
Stand.
You got to learn how to control that. You got all that untapped potential, huh? Don't be sad. I see your eyes welling. Don't well.
But no, it's the truth, though, because Because it's easier if you just see somebody as a genius and born yes. that way, then you don't have to hold yourself to any type of standard right. that, like that. You're like, well, they can do that. They, this is why y'all be tripping on me, but this is why I am such a fan of Beyonce. I remember she could not sing as well as she does now.
Listen.
She nor could she dance as well.
We were talking about this the day me and Melissa took the pictures. And I'll say it again, and I mean no disrespect. Actually, Nell said it wasn't me. She said Beyonce is not a genius. Beyonce's work ethic is what separates her from people. Mm-hmm. We watched Beyonce. Destiny's Child was great. And we're going to end with this other part, which is on the doc, is perfect. Destiny's Child was great, but I didn't see at that moment watching Destiny's Child. I mean, obviously, Beyonce was the lead singer. She was fantastic, and I liked the song. But nothing about her made me think, she's going to be a star. She's going to be bigger than the group. And she's going to be one of the greatest stars of all time.
I saw it.
You did not, Angel.
No, I did.
What did you see? In what song? On what day?
There was a song that she didn't have the notes to sing live. That's what I do know. She only had the notes in the studio. But I was just like, she's still out here trying to get that note. She is not.
Oh, you saw the flashes?
Yeah, I was like, she's trying to get this note. Like, she could have easily just been like, nope, going to phone it in. And I was like, oh, see, this child right here is, like, and also because she was the lead singer, that definitely helped. But I was just like, if she were the person that to keep working, she's going to be unstoppable. And luckily she did.
And the thing I like the most about her documentary is just how much work went into that doggone Coachella.
Yes.
Post the birth of twins.
Post the birth of twins on a crazy diet.
Working harder than anybody else and controlling everything. I was like, that's what it takes. Low key, when I did the Toby video, I really had more of an appreciation for his skill and diligence and work because he does all that for every song.
Yeah.
Choreography, he has a part in. Vision, mm-hmm. picks out the fabrics, the patterns. And that's after rapping.
Yeah.
And they released those songs every week. It took me 2 or 3 months to do that song.
Yeah. Yeah.
But Beyonce, man, when I was watching, I was like, this woman got her hand in everything. Now, when I saw Crazy in Love, I was like, ooh, okay. Mm-hmm. But I mean, just to like say my name, but I never watched all this stuff. I just took her in like I was taking all the other
artists. Yeah.
But I want to leave with this. I just saw this on Twitter this morning. And I'm glad you brought up Beyonce because it's perfect timing.
She's my fan.
Okay, now you got to listen to the setup clearly. And listeners, listen to the setup clearly and only go on what I said. Who wins in a versus matchup? Only using their group work and no solo work from either group. No solo Beyonce, Left Eye, Kelly, T-Boz, LaToya, et cetera, et cetera. Who wins? TLC by a lot, TLC by a few, Destiny's Child by a few, Destiny's Child by a lot.
Just based off of my own taste, this is why I don't think a lot of people would agree with me. I would say Destiny's Child by a few.
By your own taste?
By my own taste. Okay. There are very few TLC songs. There may be 4 or 5 that I'm just like, oh, when I hear them. I mean, because nobody in TLC could really, really sing. They could sing, but they couldn't really, really sing.
I'll give you that.
You know what I'm saying? So I probably enjoyed Left Eye more than Chili or T-Boz.
I loved Left Eye.
All of her rap hooks. I was like, okay, yes, get it. So for me, Destiny's Child just has, like, literally, I can listen to their album from start to finish and vibe out. I can't do that with TLC.
I vote TLC.
Okay.
By a few. Mm-hmm. TLC is a bigger group. TLC has sold more. I get with you on the singing thing.
They have?
Yeah.
Really?
Let me double check because now you make me doubt myself. TLC was selling crazy. Let me see.
Highest selling female group of all time.
It is
Spice Girls. Let me see.
TLC is the best selling American girl group with 65 million sold in total. Spice Girls have 85 million since the group.
Jesus. 85 million.
How many did Destiny's Child? I thought TLC was the number one.
Destiny's Child is like two under. They have 60 million. So TLC has 65 million. Destiny's Child has 60 million.
Okay.
Okay.
It was closer than I thought. I also think TLC navigated different styles of hip hop really well. Back when Left Eye was wearing the condom over her eye, Ain't Too Proud to Beg era, all the way to No Scrubs.
Yes.
That was a successful navigation of a very different type of music. Fan Mail versus Crazy Sexy Cool, very different albums versus, I don't know what the album, is it called Ain't Too Proud to Beg? That's what it was. Say it one more time, Liz. Ooh, on the TLC tip. I'm working on this joke for a tour. I had a real beef with TLC.
What?
During the No Scrubs era.
Because you were the scrub.
Not only was I the scrub, the moment I heard, and this is a true story, I kid you not, El Paso, Texas in 10th grade, the moment I first heard that song on the radio, I was literally hanging out of the passenger side of my best friend's ride. I didn't have a car or a license or I was just not trying to holler, but I was literally had my arm outside of the window and the song came on. No. And he said, hanging out the passenger side of my best friend's ride. And I was like,
trying to holler. I ain't hollering nobody.
I don't have my family's poor. We live in a trailer.
That's crazy. You were the scrub.
I was like Michael Jordan said, I took that personally. Like, I felt like, dang, I did nothing to y'all. Why y'all said this? I felt like they were like, hey, psst, broke boy Kevin, you ain't got no car, do you, broke boy?
That song was an anthem.
And everybody in El Paso, I mean, everybody everywhere, probably.
Yeah.
But all the little, nah, fool, you ain't got no car in the passenger side, fool. I was like, duh! And then when Sporty Thieves came out with No Pigeons, I was like, we're back, guys.
Oh, I never heard No Pigeons.
You ain't heard No Pigeons?
Who is Sporty Thieves?
They only made No Pigeons. I don't want No Pigeons. You never heard No Pigeons?
I don't know, I heard No Pigeons. Oh,
Sporty Thieves to the rescue. You never heard this?
Maybe.
A pigeon is a girl who be walking by. My ripped up blue brand new sparkling five. A feet hurt so you know she's born to ride.
I heard it obviously 20 years ago. I think I heard it on the radio like once or twice.
It wasn't as big of a hit as
no. Oh, no.
So No Pigeons right now has 1.7 million views on YouTube.
Oh, man.
They didn't even try to. No Scrubs has 263 million. We might as well listen. Left Eye's verse on this song.
Left Eye was an underrated rapper.
I wasn't even mad at her when she burnt down Andre Rison's house. I was like, why are you playing with Left Eye? You think she'd be here for the games?
She's not here for the games.
She was. She said she didn't mean to burn the whole house down. She's just trying to make a point. But also, she was like, and.
And it happened.
But also.
Buster.
Candy Burris, I'll never forgive you.
Sits on his broke ass. No, I don't want your number. I don't want to give you mine and no. I don't want to meet you nowhere, no. I don't want none of your time, I know. I don't want no scrubs. Can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride. Trying to holler at me.
They are the smallest women.
They are tiny. I met T-Boz. So nice.
They are that little.
Trying to holler at me.
Him is kind of weak, and it's know that he cannot approach me. And he's looking like that, and he's looking like that. Can't get with a deadbeat. So, no, I don't want your number.
Chili look like this right now today.
She's a vampire.
No, I don't want to meet you nowhere. No, I don't want none of your time. I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a lion, get no love from me.
I could actually hear Candy singing this.
Yes.
I can hear it.
When she said she wrote No Scrubs, I said, yeah, you did.
Of course you did.
Yes, you did. Hanging out the messenger. Because this is when you could have a million words in a song. It'd be okay. And you walk. Oh, yes.
Ooh, and I spent a lot.
I'm talking to you.
My little walkman.
With your mama. Oh, yes.
She was literally like.
Baby. Don't show
it was very personal.
When they get with me with no money on you, I don't want no love.
The makeup was dope in this.
No love. No.
They were little.
No. Very small.
Very little.
No.
It's going off.
Damn.
This is when TRL and 106 in Park were still thing.
Oh, God, it was so great.
Was 106 in Park even out yet?
No, I don't think so.
You kidding?
No. From me.
All right, left eye. Hit him with it, left eye.
Then it leaves you in a class with scrubs, never rising. I don't find a surprise, and if you don't have the cheese, to please me and bounce from here to the coast of overseas. So, let me give you something to think about. Thinking to let your mind with intentions to turn you out. Forget to focus on the picture in front of me. You would clear as DVD on digital TV screens. Satisfy my appetite with something spectacular. Vernacular. And then I get back to you. Like diamond like precision. Insatiable is what I envision. Can't detect acquisition from your friend's expedition. Listen to me. If you really want to know, ask Chile. Could I be a silly hoe?
She just had so much swag.
Oh, she was the best.
She was what?
She was the best.
Oh, the best. No. Okay, before we go, just one more ode to Left Eye. I just want to hear her verse on Waterfall. Sporty Thieves never had another hit single.
I know, that was it.
But boy, it restored my confidence.
Yeah, no pigeons.
He was so pissed off. They couldn't even sing. I don't want no pigeons.
This was the
boy, this
saddest
man
song.
Everybody was dying in this video.
Oh, my God, dang. This is why I love me some Destiny's Child. They got, I woke up this morning, the sunshine was shining. I put on a happy fit.
I was like, they were like, don't get AIDS.
No, I was like, oh, my
God. AIDS, guys. This video was so freaking dope.
Oh, yeah. Organized Noise, right?
Yeah.
From that documentary.
Yes.
I had no idea.
Me neither. It's a great documentary. I mean, car accidents.
I know.
His mom was acting.
Oh, no. I used to want to act in a music video.
Nothing to me. Jump.
Oh, we're not there. I
forgot the music video.
They got all
the I'm singing the song. Boy, the 90s, they loved a person disappearing.
Oh, yeah.
That when whoever learned that trick, they was like, we can knock, they'll be there.
And then they'd be gone.
It happened in pictures disappearing. They was like, do the disappear. You know how?
Disappearing.
Yes. He was on that corner selling them drugs. Is that Bokeem Woodbine? And he sought cuz out and he died? There was a gunshot and they stole the crack?
The laces you used to.
Having no way or nothing at all. But I think you're moving too fast. See, we would have been at her verse if it wasn't for that breakdown. They was all shoulders and smiles.
Yeah.
They love the good.
She gives him love and that his body can handle. All he can say is, baby, it's good to me. The mirror,
this song had
and
words.
He doesn't recognize his home face.
Did you see this at the mall?
No, it was too depressing. Thing this one.
Took him to his final rest. Yacht on him, man.
Oh my God. That condom. That's what they. Listen, they was heavy handed with the innuendo. Take the condom. You won't get AIDS, but it's going to feel good this time. She literally slid that out. Like, that's toxic femininity.
Mm-hmm. She's like.
And there go more disappearing people. That's all the people she had sex with in that picture.
Go. And I was like, oh, she's a black widow.
Hey, this is a heavy video.
Yes.
You died. The sun died.
I was like,
AIDS.
Can't do it. Gonna have it, you ain't nothing
at all. But I think you're moving too fast. Here we go, left eye. Come
on. I seen a rainbow yesterday. Even too many storms. I'm coming for leaving a trace. I'm not one
God given raise it. But that's my life. It was shades of gray. I pray us and fade away. No more crying eyes. And like this promise is true. Only my faith can undo. The many chances I believe would bring my life to an end. Clear No more lonely eyes. My only hope is for the folk who can't cope with such an enduring pain that it keeps them in the pouring rain. Who's to blame for two things? Chili never got her own part.
Not in this song.
Not in most songs.
No. Scrubs, wasn't that Chili?
Girls, you know that was T-Boss? The rest is up to be you. They were like, Chili, damn. Rosanna didn't get no lead. I'm sure. All right, y'all. God bless y'all. Thank you for rocking with us. Please pull up the Keep Your Distance this Friday. It is the final one for a good long while. We love you, Patreon. Stick around for the love hour where you saw how much you got, Angel. Did you see how much you got on the Patreon? Patreon done bless Angel with housewarming gift. It's taken her all the way out. She avoided looking at her Chili was first in Scrubs. Well, hush, man. I ain't listening to you, Angel. Angel don't know what to do with herself because y'all done blessed her. Josh, take it out when I said Chili didn't get no parts. Make me seem like I was right. All right. Thank God bless y'all. So Angel don't know what to do with herself. We love y'all. See you at the conference.
Thank you. Bye. Here's another thing of fire. Here's another one. Here's another thing of fire. Here's another one. Here's another thing of fire. Fire. Here's another bang of fire. With my boy Kev on stage. And that chick Angel.